Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to change by increasing or decreasing the product price conditionally. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. Before we get started, let's go ahead and create a feed with some products and prices. I'm going to use custom one here. I've already configured this to United States. I've kept the feed type to CSV so we can easily compare the prices. English, USD, and I've only kept four attributes, the ID, title, condition, and price. Let's update and generate this feed. Once it's ready, let's go ahead and download it and have a look. So this is what the feed looks like. As you can see, we have some products and their relative prices. Now we're going to create some attributes that's going to dynamically change these prices according to the conditions that we create. So let's go ahead and do that. Now we're going to go ahead and create a dynamic attribute for the new prices that we want. So scroll down and click on dynamic attributes. Once you're here, click on add new to create a new dynamic attribute. Let's give it a name, new price. And we'll add some conditions. Let's say when regular price is greater than 20, we'll change this to pattern. It will return as a value of, let's say, plus 10. So that means if the price is greater than $20, it will increase it by $10 more. Let's add another condition. Let's say when regular price is less than 20, let's change this to pattern as well. We're going to have a 10% increase. So let's say plus 10%. And for our default value, we're just going to keep it at regular price. Let's save that. Now our dynamic attribute has been successfully created and we're ready to put this into our feed. Now let's go ahead and configure the new price into our feed. So go back to custom one. I'll clear the case so that the new attribute that you've created shows up. Once that's done, let's scroll down and look at the new attribute that we have created. There we go, dynamic attribute, new price. Let's update and generate this feed. Now let's download it and have a look. There we go guys. Now as you can see, the prices have changed according to the dynamic attribute we have created. Let's copy this table and paste it with our old file so that we can compare it next to each other. Now let's compare our regular prices with the new dynamic attribute. As you can see, since $50 is more than 20, we have added $10 here. Same goes for our hoodie, we have added an extra $10. Because 20 does not fall under any of the conditions, this remains as 20. And here we have the beanie and the belt. As you can see, $10 is less than 20. So what happens is there is a 10% increase, which increases the price by $1. So it's changed from 10 to 11 and 10 to 11 from here. Now let's go ahead and add a few more products onto our feed. Let's say we're going to add this cap, which is just $5. We're going to add the sunglasses, which is at $150. And we'll add this album, which is at $220. Now let's go back to our dynamic attribute and add a few more conditions for our prices. So we'll go down to new price. Let's add a few more conditions. Now let's say when the regular price is in between these two prices. So what you do is you put the first price in, you separate it by a comma and you put the second price in. We're going to make this a pattern. Let's say you're going to get a 20% discount. So let's put minus 20%. As you can see, we can also use the minus sign similar to how we have used the plus sign. And let's add another one. Let's say when the regular price is in between, let's say 200 and 300, we're going to give them a bigger discount of, let's say 50%. Minus 50%. Let's do that. Let's add another one. Let's say when the regular price is less than $10, we want it to be a little bit more than that. So we're going to change that to times 1.5. So I'll multiply it this time around. Similar to the multiplication sign here, if we put in this, it will actually divide this value by 1.5. But for now, let's keep it at multiplication. Let's go ahead and save it. Time to go back to our feed and regenerate it. Let's go to CTX Feed. Regenerate this file. Let's download the new file and see what it looks like. Now I have put the two tables beside each other once again, where we have the old price and the new price. As you can see, for our new products that we have added, the cap, which was under $10 at 5, is multiplied by 1.5, making it 7.5. The sunglasses, which was in between $100 and $200, got itself a 20% discount. The album, which was in between $200 and $300, has gotten itself a 50% discount. There you go, guys. Now you know how to increase or decrease your product price conditionally for your feed. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.